Hey guys, this is Nick, and as you might have read or heard, PopOS will probably replace GNOME in the future by a desktop environment of their own making. And surprisingly, we already know quite a few things about that new desktop, and it also prompted a bunch of thoughts, on my part at least, on how it's a good thing for the Linux desktop as a whole. So let's take a look at all we know and what I think about it. So earlier this month, a PopOS desktop engineer casually dropped on a Reddit conversation that yes, PopOS would probably move to something else than GNOME. It wouldn't be a fork of GNOME, a fork of KDE, or just plain old KDE. It would be an entirely new desktop environment written in Rust. So what do we know already about this desktop? Just from the stuff that has been said in the Reddit conversation, it's actually quite a lot. So first, it will be called Cosmic, just like the current GNOME plus extensions configuration that PopOS ships. Second, it will be written in Rust, from scratch, so it won't be a fork of GNOME or of another desktop. Now, I don't know the advantages of Rust over other languages, but I'm sure a lot of people will cheer and a lot of others will eye roll. Programmation language nerds, man. Third, it will follow the free desktop specification, so it will be interoperable with other desktops. Now, they also seem to aim for more stability and less resource usage than GNOME, with greater configuration options. Now we also know a lot of smaller things. It will be compatible with Wayland and X11, and probably will reuse an existing window manager. It will use GTK for some components, but the shell itself won't use a traditional GUI toolkit and will be lower level, so expect more performance if it's developed correctly. Now the idea seems to be reusing tools that already exist, but bind them into a new shell that's been developed and written completely to allow for PopOS to do whatever the hell they want. Basically, they're taking the same approach as what Ubuntu did with Unity back in the day, which is, don't bother rewriting all the applications if you don't need to, just rewrite the shell, the thing that you're not satisfied with. Now, it seems that their idea is also to have other distributions being able to use Cosmic as a shell on their distributions, which is currently very difficult to do. For now, no one would really use what they've built because it's basically one version behind main GNOME plus some extensions, and supporting that plus the more current version of GNOME on a traditional distro's repo system is pretty tricky. Now this means that we can probably expect an Ubuntu Cosmic Remix or Manjaro Cosmic Edition and whatever other combinations that you can think of. Now of course, with a new thing that doesn't depend on GNOME's release cycle entirely, they can basically make sure that other distros have a easier time taking up this project, contributing to it, and maybe shipping it as the default. Now they also said that they're expanding their development team to be able to handle that new workload. So what will Cosmic look like? Well, basically like what today's Cosmic desktop looks like. A dock on the bottom, a top panel, a launcher to open apps and to search. It makes sense to not disturb the user's habits and to not remake the whole experience. It will also have the auto-tiling features PopOS users already enjoy. So that desktop won't be here for 22.04, that's for sure, and I personally wouldn't expect it before 2023, because PopOS is a distro that's not only available for free to download for anybody to install, but also shipped out of the box on System 76 hardware. And while you can, like, smooth over a problem with a distro that you downloaded off the internet, if your new hardware comes with something that's broken or not working as expected, you're gonna be pissed off, so I would expect System 76 to only ship it when it's really stable and ready. But why create yet another desktop environment? Won't that split development efforts and hurt the Linux desktop in general? Let's get that out of the way. This is a very common misconception, but it is not how open source works at all. First, you can't always make your own vision for something coexist with the vision the original project has. Sometimes the two are incompatible. In that case, you have two options. You create your own vision and start working on it, or you forget your vision and stop working on the previous project whose goals you no longer share. Basically, if you don't fork or create your own project, you wouldn't contribute to the original project anyways. So the desktop engineer at PopOS on this specific issue says on Reddit, "The way software works is similar to how all organizations work. You can't simply show up and expect the organization to radically change their ways just because you engage. It can often be much more of a social game than a technical one. You have to work under the conditions of the people who make the decisions as a follower of the project, rather than a leader. And only once you have managed to rise the ranks to a leadership position do you get to call the shots, or at least have the favor of someone in a leadership role. which again depends entirely on having aligned goals. Though it kinda sounds like House of Cards here, right? So basically, you can't just show up on a project and say, you know what, we want this feature, and this feature, and we're gonna work on them and develop them. Because those goals might not align with the original project's goals, and basically what's happening here is that System76's vision for a desktop and GNOME's vision for a desktop are no longer aligned. And so System76, while not being able to contribute their vision to GNOME because they probably wouldn't accept it, then they have to develop their own thing, or just accept the GNOME's vision as it is, which they don't want to do. Now, the real question is, why do System76 feel that they can no longer ship GNOME as the default to have a good experience for their users? And this is obviously a move to try and not be impacted as much by the GNOME plan changes. GNOME is moving in its own direction that PopOS hasn't really liked all that much in the past, and it doesn't seem that relations are improving, as incendiary blog posts and tweets keep being fired on a regular basis from GNOME contributors and System76 employees. They refused our patches! They never submitted any patch! They spread misinformation! Now sometimes it really does feel like the Linux community is just a bunch of toddlers, really. Now PopOS already had made a first move by renaming their shell Cosmic when they decided to ship a variety of extensions out of the box on their distro to implement a vision closer to what they'd like users to have. But it seems that these extensions aren't enough. They are in general kinda hacky, they can be broken with every major release of GNOME, and have no chance of ever getting upstreamed, so they will be a burden on System76 for however long they would decide to keep using them. It also means that they have to keep being one version late for their desktop, because maintaining all these patches for a brand new release is just not doable. So in the end, if you don't like the direction GNOME is going, keeping your dependency on GNOME is just not a good idea. Either you have to create your own thing that might reuse some GNOME bits or fork it, but that implements your own vision, or you cave in and use vanilla GNOME and accept that you're not shipping the experience to your consumers that you really wanted to ship. And that's basically unacceptable for any company that has any amount of self-respect, seriously. You don't ship something that you're not proud of. No, my opinion on this move is very positive. I love the fact that System76 is going out and developing their own thing. I loved the fact at the time that Ubuntu developed their own desktop in the form of Unity. I love having more options available for desktop environments. And I'm not just saying that because if they weren't creating their own thing, I would have less things to talk about on the channel. I also think it's generally a good thing for a distribution to have their own vision and their own differentiation options. Think about what happened when GNOME 3 was released. Before, you only really had KDE, GNOME, and XFCE. Three desktop environments, one for simplicity, one for customization, and one for performance. After GNOME 3, you added Unity, Cinnamon, and Mate to the list, and later Budgie. You basically more than doubled the number of desktop environments on Linux. Would anyone say that this is a bad thing? That getting Cinnamon and Mint was a bad thing? That getting another vision in Unity, which ended up also resulting in Ubuntu Touch being developed, was a bad thing? I don't think so. It all contributed to making the Linux desktop ecosystem a more vibrant, a more energetic, a more competitive space. It's a good thing. Basically, I think that each distribution should have its own specific thing that makes it unique, or it doesn't really have a reason to exist. Elementary OS has its own desktop environment and app center. Fedora has all the latest tech. Arch is the most bleeding edge distro. Gentoo is super optimized for your hardware, and a lot of other distros bring their own more minor spins on these bases that serve a purpose. And I think PopOS will serve more of a purpose over baseline Ubuntu if it's not just a collection of GNOME extensions on top of Ubuntu. Though I also think that System76, as a company that not only makes a distribution but also makes computers that are shipped with that distribution, I think that as a company they have to do it. They have to have as much control as they can over the whole stack, hardware and software. And not in an Apple walled garden thing, because it's still built on open source bits and pieces, but just because they want to ship the experience to their customers that they really feel they can work on and they can be proud of. If you buy a $1,000 computer, you're not gonna be as lenient on various bugs or problems or limitations of your distribution than if you just downloaded it off the internet for free. With an experience that they can control entirely from top to bottom, it makes a whole lot of a difference. They can be proud of what they shipped, they can be sure that quality control is on point, And also their customers will be more satisfied, and it makes a bunch of difference with other vendors and manufacturers that use the same Clevo or Tongfeng chassis but can't really work on their own distribution as much as System 76 is doing. I want to see more difference, more meaningful difference between distributions. That's also why I don't do distro reviews on the channel, because apart from the main ones, they are generally just a reskin that I could replicate in a few hours. A theme, a few extensions, a few specific default apps, another file system. It's not meaningful for the user. It doesn't make for a meaningful, different experience. And I want distributions to be more different. And I think that's what PopOS is going to be if they work on their own desktop operating system. And I think it's a great thing. So this video was made possible by Slimbook. You probably all already know about Slimbook by now. What you have to know is that they're a Linux hardware manufacturer. They're based in Valencia, Spain, and I only use their devices nowadays. I use their Slimbook Pro X14 laptop and their Slimbook Chimera desktop that you see in the background here. They're amazing devices, super well tailored. You can have them with any keyboard layout shipped to anywhere in the world. They work really well, and they have affordable options and pricier options. Check the link in the description below if you need a new Linux device. They're really, really good. So thank you guys for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't hesitate to like and subscribe. And if you didn't, you can also hit that dislike button and tell me why in the comments while YouTube still shows that dislike counter. And well, that's about it. If you want to help support the channel, you can also join my Patreon subscribers and YouTube members. You'll get access to a weekly Patreon cast and the right to vote on the next topics I'll cover. And if you hate YouTube, I don't know why you're here, but you can also go watch my stuff on Odyssey, because everything is there as well. So thank you guys for watching, and I guess I will see you in the next one. Bye!